Hey guys, so color combinations. I mean, we get this question a lot, and specifically, you guys want to know what are the best color combos you can wear in your outfit that's perfect for fall. And I mean, now that we're really in the thick of this season, why not do a video covering our favorite combinations so that you can be looking sharp?
The main thing you need to know before you start looking at color combinations is what your skin tone is or what your complexion is, because that will absolutely impact the types and ways you can wear color during this season, of course, but obviously year round as well.
So if you're pale, then darker colors are actually your best friend. You wanna shy away from anything too light because that's really going to shine a spotlight on how pale you are. And that's not necessarily, I think, what you want to do.
And if you have more of an olive skin tone or complexion, the one thing you probably need to avoid or just be really careful about is yellows and how you pair it into your outfit, because then it can really wash you out and clashes with your skin tone. But really outside of that, you get to go wild.
And if you have a darker skin tone, then well, my friend, the world is your oyster. You get to go crazy with colors. Okay, so during the cooler months, you're basically going to be experimenting with darker jewel tones and earthy tones. Now, the first color combination I want to start with, we're going to focus on a dark forest green. And what that pairs really well with is navy. I mean, these two color combos are just like, mwah!
The Tom and Jerry of earth tony fall colors, right,
yes,
Ash?
Yes, I mean, they look great year round, but the darker green with the darker navy color, it's really rich and they really complement anything that you're gonna be wearing during this time of year. And blue and green really help brighten up and freshen up your complexion, so it complements every man out there.
So Ash, if they're pairing these colors, do they need to worry about like what's on bottom and what's on top? Like, can you mix and match, or is one more relegated to the bottom half
or
the other?
So the beauty of a green and blue combo is that you do not have to even think about, oh, this color should be on top in terms of like, it should be my jacket color and this color should be my pant color. You can mix and match with this, it doesn't matter.
And the next way to pair forest green in an outfit is with brown. And we are talking like literal fall colors, like literally it's the color of the trees and the leaves changing. So it's too perfect not to dress and add to your forest green outfit, right, Ash?
Yes, definitely. I mean, this is a very sharp look. It's a really good color combination, especially if you want to wear a little bit kind of a different color combo. I mean, everyone has navy in their wardrobe, but not everyone has brown and not everyone has green. And these two marry together beautifully. And of course, another beautiful neutral is charcoal, which pairs great with a forest green color. I mean, especially if you're a little bit more sensitive to color, maybe you're just starting.
What color is that?
You're just starting to experiment. It's okay. Always great to just keep one item one item that is the color, like the standout color, like in this case, it would be forest green, and keep the rest of the outfit neutral, which gray, as we know, is a neutral color.
Okay, so we've established a green, like a forest green is like a jewel tone that you can play with, but what about like an earthy tone? What should the guys do out there, Ash?
So camel is a great earthy tone that pairs very well with a gray, like a charcoal gray or even a lighter gray. I mean, everyone should have at least one camel piece in their wardrobe. Usually what we'll recommend is either a chino pant or an outerwear jacket. So it could be a coat or a bomber jacket or a trucker jacket that is in a camel color. But camel and gray pair perfectly together, and it's just another great fall color that you can easily add into your wardrobe, and you don't really have to think about it or worry about your skin tone and whether your complexion is going to go with camel or not.
And this next color combo, I see pictures of, or I see like guys wearing it during this time of year, and I'm like, oh, that looks fantastic, I should do the same thing. And then I put it on and I'm just like, I don't know if that's quite for me. It's not that it doesn't work, but there's just something that I'm just not comfortable with.
You're also very shy with color.
Yeah, I am. But what is it, Ash? What should they do?
So this is a deep, dark jewel tone. It's a burgundy or like a really deep red wine color. And this color pairs well with either black or navy. Now, I know why that you're like a little weird about this color.
I don't know why. I just put it on me. I'm just like, No, I don't like it.
So here's the goal. It's because when you choose a burgundy, you're actually choosing more of a bright burgundy. You want to go super, super dark. So think when you're pouring yourself a glass of red wine, like you want to go that deep, dark.
Deep, rich color.
Yeah, a deep, rich color, because that's really going to complement everyone out there. And it's going to not be such a standout color, but it's enough color where it shows that you have like really great style and you know how to dress during the fall and winter months.
I think the easiest way to look at this color is if you typically wear like oranges or reds during the warmer time of year, like spring and summer, burgundy is absolutely what you should transition to for the fall and winter months.
Now to wear burgundy, I actually really love it when guys just use it in their jacket color versus a sweater or t-shirt or pants. A jacket color is enough to have that pop of color, but not be too loud. And wearing it this way, especially if you are a pale gentleman, will make sure that it doesn't bring out any kind of pink undertones that you might have.
And speaking of navy, Ashley, and guys out there.
You're wearing navy.
I am. This is obviously a cooler time, so your shades of color should be darker in this respect. So you probably want to avoid like a royal blue in this respect.
Yeah.
But this is one of my favorite combinations, and that's navy with gray. I mean, basic, basic, basic. Yes, I know that, but it still looks good. So that's one of my favorites. That's what I typically pull out this time of year. I would wear a navy shirt like this or sweater with some gray pants, or flip the script and do it vice versa. I just think it pairs perfectly well, and that is absolutely one of my go-tos this year.
Okay, so these next two color combinations is really where I see a lot of guys go wrong here. I mean, and I get it. They're definitely a little bit trickier of a color to wear, but if you get it right, oh my gosh, it looks fantastic.
Sploosh, would you say?
I don't know what that means. So the first combination that I want to talk to you guys about is basically like a burnt orange, rust, a copper color that pairs great with navy. So everyone can wear this color combination, but depending on your skin tone, that's going to really dictate which piece should be that rust, you know, copper, burnt orange color. So if you are a pale gentleman, you should probably relegate the burnt orange rust color to your jacket and then do a navy shirt, because you really want that darker navy color to kind of help, I would say, break up the orange color against your skin tone, because otherwise it's gonna make you look either really flushed or a little bit sickly.
So if you wore a orange shirt and a navy jacket, that's when it looks a little weird, because I think there's no break in your skin, right?
Yeah,
is that what it
like,
is?
It's like your shirt leads up to your neck, which leads up to your face. So that's where it can be a little tricky. I mean, you know, obviously there's always gonna be exceptions, but this is like a really easy rule to follow. Keep it in your jacket for the rust color, or even better, if you're a little still nervous, just insert the rust or the burnt orange color into your accessories. Now, if you have olive skin, I mean, you don't have to worry about it. You can wear the burnt orange in your shirt color. You can wear the burnt orange in your jacket color, your pants, like it doesn't matter. And this also will apply if you are a darker skin color as
well.
Go
nuts.
Yeah, you can go nuts. It doesn't matter which item is rust, you know, burnt orange. Oh, you know, the one that I don't want to forget, yellow skin tone. So for all my Asians out there, like myself, you are going to basically be lumped in with the pale people. You don't want to wear your burnt orange.
I feel you.
With your shirting. Just do it on outerwear or your
accessories.
Pants or accessories. And the next color combination that is great for fall, but it's definitely a little tricky to pull off, is yellow and navy.
Now, Ash, there's such a wide variety of yellows out there. I hope the guys understand out there, you're not wearing bright, bright yellow during this time
Absolutely
of year. What type of yellow are we talking about?
You want to do a dark mustardy yellow. That's the yellow I'm talking about. Nothing bright, nothing light. You want a really deep, dark yellow. Now there's a couple things you need to consider. If you are pale, or you have yellow skin tone or a olive skin tone, then you've got to kind of adjust how you wear the mustard yellow color.
Tread lightly, friends.
Yes, so what you want to do is you want to really stick with accessories, like, again, your watch strap, pocket square, socks,
tie,
those are all really great.
Can you do a hat that's like mustard yellow?
No,
nothing touching your face.
Nothing touching your face, nothing touching your skin. You want to stick with accessories, or you can wear the mustard yellow in your pants as well. Now, you could wear it in your jacket, but then you get in a whole host of other rules that you gotta apply and really like follow, only because this is the thing. Mustard yellow can really wash you out and make you look actually rather drab and sickly.
So guys, you need to understand something. I'm sure there are pictures out there where someone with my skin tone or a yellow skin tone or an olive skin tone is wearing mustard yellow in a big jacket, bright outfit, and they look great. But here's what you have to understand. In pictures is one thing.
Yeah.
In person is a completely separate thing. In pictures, they're controlling every single aspect of how that looks. The lighting, the detail, the focal length. I mean, literally everything goes into that. In real life, that's when it will look odd, and that's obviously what we all live in. So you have to be careful and not see a picture and be like, see, it looks fantastic. And then you wear it and you're like, oh.
Now, if you have a darker complexion, then you can wear the mustard yellow in any piece of your clothing. So it could be like a sweater, it could be a full suit, it could be a jacket, it could be
accessories,
the pants,
scarf, beanies, etc.
It could be the scarf, beanie. You don't have to worry about it because it's gonna pop beautifully against your darker complexion.
I'm jealous.
But there's still ways for you to wear mustard yellow, but
there
remember,
is.
Perfect combination is with navy. It's just a classic color combination that really works well during the fall season.
All right, guys, thanks so much for watching. We'll see you in the next one.
Bye.